And then it goes, I'll tell you then, I'll tell you when it's now. No, no, no. You don't like it?
No.
Oh. It goes, I'll tell you then, I'll tell you when it's now. No, 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 no. Can you sing that? Do you want me to make a sandcastle?
A butter.
A what?
A butter.
Beetle? Can you say beetle? Beetle.
Beetle.
Bee. So, not a bee. Beetle, different from a bee. Should we sing the song again? He goes, I'll tell you when, I'll tell you when it's
no.
Now. Well done.
Good bleh. And then I started kissing her and then going bleh. And now she wants to do it all the time.
Bleh.
Bleh.
Who knows why, what, how, or when? This is Waltz with Bess and Fen. Oh, this is Waltz with Bess and Fen.
There are places I'll remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not far better. Some have gone, and some have stayed. All these places have their moments, with lovers and friends I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one who compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I loved you.
Can you explain what's happening here, Ryan?
Well, Fen's helping me with the merch. Fen, which is not really.
Fen, are you helping with the merch, darling?
Good. Martin, you've been blessed.
Fen is doing a drawing on Martin's package. Let's see that drawing close up. pretty good.
What are you drawing? Yeah. Yeah? You feel it? Let me know when you're done. You done? One more bit.
Your flight delay, go learn Italian. Find a girl with a gold medallion, the birds will poo right on your head. It's just the way of showing you affection. Lost your keys, befriend a neighbor. Maybe she's got a story to save her. I tell you fair and I tell you when it's not. No, 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 no. I tell you fair. Stuck in traffic, the mind is an addict, but I thought said it to Patrick. Broke my phone, so I went to the zoo. Did you know you can talk to the animals too? I tell you fair, I'll tell you when it's na 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 na. I tell you fair. Job, so I left the island. Now I work for my best friend Simon. Lost a tenor on a platform, but maybe a cold heart is now warm. I tell you fan, I'll tell you when it's now. Now, 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 now. I tell you fair and I'll tell you when it's now. Now, 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 now. I tell you fair and I'll tell you when it's now. Outro chair. Somebody's sitting there.
Cool. Yeah, has a bird ever pooed on your head?
No, actually, I was thinking about it when I heard the song. No, and when I heard the song first time, I was walking in Rome, and then I was like, oh shit. I see lots of pigeons just flying around, and I was really nervous that they would poo on me. But at the same time, I was like hoping that they will, because then I can talk about it.
Do you have any other superstitions while we're on superstitions? Personal ones, maybe that only you have.
Well, this is kind of normal for like all Taiwanese people. I will always knock on the door before I go to a hotel room, just in case some other spirits living there. Okay. Which is quite cool. As in, like, I'd rather believe it than not believe it.
Sure, but it's a hotel room.
Yeah, yeah. Because there are so many rooms in the hotels. So then, say, maybe half of the time, if they're not occupied, another spirit or soul can go in there. Which I know. That's just something really minor I do, but I just make it like, really quick. And then sometimes if, you know, if someone from the hotel is like taking you to the room, you're like, oh shit, he's gonna open the door for me, and I can't knock on the door.
What would you do in that?
I'll just do a still, but I don't like
it. Like a really quick one, like knock and push.
Like, just to inform, I'm also coming in.
Of course. Okay.
So it's also a good idea. Would you not do that to anyone's house?
No, but then I'll ring the doorbells and stuff. And I'm not living there though.
Oh,
if
okay,
I go
okay,
to someone
okay,
else's
okay,
house.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I'm not intruding. Like, I'm not just like coming into your house, not telling you, knocking on your door, and then just start like lying on the bed, making myself comfortable. Yeah.
Do you have anyone who you would send kind of, you know, just a very random thought? Do you have someone who you could send random thoughts to just in the, just at any time? Which are quite little
maybe
thoughts.
So my friend Kitty and I, we take pictures of say two of the same, like two people who wear exactly the same thing, either it's like kids or old ladies, but it has to be kind of eccentric. It can't just be like, oh yeah, they just like wear the same clothes. Yeah, so we do that quite often. Or like two people with like nearly identical long hair. I love it so much.
So you have to go and take pictures of these people though?
Yeah, I'm quite good at that.
So you're quite good at it. The song is loosely about, obviously it's like turning negative situations into positive situations.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Can you think of like how you, either an example about how you may have done that at some point in your life?
Say for example, if you got dragged to, I don't know, a party, or your mom asked you to go somewhere you don't want to be. But I always feel, because I will get really fascinated by how other people do things. Even to go to a restaurant I don't want to go, or go to someone else's flat that I don't know of. So I feel really awkward being there. But I always tend to see the things they do which excite me. So for example, like something really small, like the tablecloth or table arrangement, or the curtain that they chose is like super shiny pink. And I'll be like, oh, I think I start to like you, or something like that. Like, I'll try and look at the details to make myself immerse or like the situation. That's what I kind of do. Something really minor, but it helps.
You know, how do I make a successful restaurant? I'm really interested in starting a cafe, a restaurant, or something when I'm older.
Yeah.
What would you say to them?
Opening restaurant isn't something like, oh my god, I really want to do. You know, it's not like born to like want to open restaurants and stuff, but it's because there are elements in there I really want to do. Therefore, I did it. Yeah. We always want to create spaces where you can eat. You can eat and you feel really buzzed. Like, I love, if you go to, yeah, I love performers. I love like people interaction in a space. Say for example, for the Soho, Bao Soho, everyone's so close to each other, and I really love it because you are nudging into someone else, and the whole vibe is if you are in a painting or you're in a movie, and that's something we love creating. Therefore, everything for that space becomes smaller, become narrow, become closer to each other. But that's because I like that part of it. But if you like, say, you love making bread or love making coffee, then just get into it. You know?
You can't get in.
What is that wish that you never did make? The one lost to the winds and the honest mistakes. Your one dream that never found the right day. Oh, I love you forever, so don't go away.